Our main stories at the time, coming up to 10 past eight. Now, we were telling you about that bank story. The money that high street banks are making out of borrowers has increased, in some cases, ninefold over the last 3 years. That's according to a new analysis of interest rates, which has been carried out for BBC Breakfast.
Well, the chair of the Commons Treasury Select Committee, Andrew Tyrie, says our figures will now form part of an investigation into what he's described as unsustainable borrowing rates. Our personal finance correspondent, Samantha Washington, has been investigating.
Whether it's buying a car, shopping, paying for the mortgage, most of us are borrowing money. But are the interest rates we're being charged fair?
I think my mortgage rate is too high. And I wish it was lower because the Bank of England rate is a lot lower.
I have a couple of credit cards, well, actually three, I think. And a couple of those are charging me very high rates.
It's unfair, really, because we've just found out that our rate has yet again been increased. And we are now at the point where we can't really afford to pay our mortgage.
Banks pay for the money they lend to us. We pay them an interest rate on what we borrow. And it's the difference between what they pay and what we pay them that's their cut. But are the banks making too much out of us?
We've been crunching the figures for different types of borrowing. In 2007, the bank's markup on an unsecured loan, like a loan to buy a car, was 3.5%. Now that cut has increased over threefold to 12.3%. With credit cards, banks' takings have nearly doubled, increasing from 10.8% to 18.2%. But it's on mortgages that the bank's markup has increased most. 3 years ago, if you took out a fixed rate, the bank's cut was less than 0.5%. Now, on the same mortgage, they'd take over 3%. That's a ninefold increase.
Mortgages are noticeably higher, and it doesn't stop there. Credit cards, overdrafts, and personal loans are at historical highs as well. Banks are looking to repair trying to repair the balance sheet, and the customers taking the brunt.
We showed our figures to the chair of the Treasury Select Committee.
Whether or not these margins are unreasonable, and I think they probably are, they're certainly unsustainable. What we've got to remember is that a good number of these banks are partly or wholly owned, more or less wholly owned, by the government. And the taxpayer has just been bailing these banks out. This is exactly the sort of issue that the Treasury Committee will want to be investigating, and I've no doubt this sort of research, the research you've just done, among other things, will be high on our agenda.
But the banks say new rules to make the industry safer makes lending more expensive.
The actual cost of being in business for a bank has risen very, very dramatically. You've got to hold much more capital, that's dead money, and it just adds to the cost to the bank, and so it flows through to the cost to the customer.
With many banks announcing unexpected profits last month, customers will hope to see some of the benefit. Samantha Washington, BBC News.
Well, what do the banks have to say? Angela Knight is here from the British Bankers Association. Morning, Angela.
Morning. Good morning.
Well, people can say, God, the banks, they're at it again. Mm,
they probably will say that, but unfortunately, or fortunately, it's not the case. I mean, I think investigation's rather a good idea because there's a lot of things that make up, you know, the cost of credit, how much people pay. Base rate, bank rate is one. But, of course, how much it costs a bank to get the finances is much more than that. The new rules, as I've said, that's there as well. But out on the high street, there's a lot of competition too. So some of the figures that you've given, yes, they may be averages, but you'll see a lot of variations out there. So it's kind of mixed in.
If they're averages, that means the margins are even bigger in some cases.
Well, I think you will find that with all the major high street banks, they're operating very competitive rates, both on the lending side and on the borrowing side. And the totality of what people are paying for mortgages, in most instances, that has shown quite a considerable drop compared with, say, 3 years ago.
Not on the savings side. There are lots of people writing in to say they've been clobbered as far as savings rates are concerned.
Well, you are.
And the banks are getting it both ways, really, because they're not giving them any money if they're saving, but they're taking lots of money if they're borrowing.
Well, actually, the banks aren't getting it either way, because as far as the savings are concerned, I mean, savings rates, yes, have come down. And although a lot of the attention has been on borrowing, you're absolutely right. People who are saving, when you've got a low interest environment, they do get less on their savings. But let me just give you a little sum. I know it's early in the morning, but let's have a go at a little sum. If, for example, somebody wants to borrow £100, well, if base rate is about 2%, and I'm adding a margin of about 2%, then for every £100, that adds up to £4. But if base rate drops to 0.5% and my margin is only 2%, then that's £2.50 I get for every £100. But I've still got the same number of people to employ. Mm-hmm. I've got more people actually getting into debt and not paying back their loans. And the actual cost of being in business has gone up from the new rules. And that's why looking at margins doesn't necessarily give the right answer. It gives some answers, but it doesn't give the right answer.
But even so, when you look at the margin on a fixed rate mortgage, it's gone up ninefold in 3 years. I mean, it was low in 2007, but a 900% increase just seems a bit out of order.
Well, I don't actually recognise that number. I appreciate that you said it in your research, but I also appreciate that you said in one instance, and I think that you'll find if you look into it, that is not actually indicative of what is happening. It is correct that some mortgages have risen, but an awful lot of mortgages have come down compared with about 3 years ago. But we are in a new world. You know, we can't suddenly pretend that somehow we're going to return to boom times when we were told we were actually lending too much, and now what we're being told is that we've got to be much more careful.
It's the cost of lending, though, Andrew. That's what people are saying. And just there's an email from Darren from Lancashire who says that he's got an interest rate on a credit card of 29%. How can I ever pay off my cards with such a ridiculous rate? I mean, that's not acceptable, surely, is it?
That certainly seems very high. And I think the answer would be twofold. Perhaps he better look to see which credit card he's with, because, again, there's a lot of choice there. But secondly, credit cards aren't for long-term borrowings. If you need a loan, you're much better to go and arrange a loan with a bank, which is at a lower interest, than borrow using a credit card, which will always be high interest, because a lot of people don't pay back their credit cards, and so that's what results in the interest on credit cards going up.
You said
there's choice to people, and there's also, if I may say, you want to do different types of borrowing for different types of requirements.
You say the boom times are gone, but the banks, as we've been hearing recently, making bumper profits, and some of those banks belong to the very people who are feeling pretty hard done by on these margins.
Well, they're certainly not making bumper profits, but you're right to say...
Well, make big profits.
You're right to say that the banks have just returned to profit, and that is a good thing, not a bad thing, because if you return to profit, it means you pay taxes, you can keep people employed, and yes, you can pay back the taxpayer. Not every bank, of course, got into trouble. The majority did not. And I think that because finance is complicated, and because, as I say, life has changed, the economy hasn't yet properly recovered, we have to accept that I'm afraid there are a lot of other things that have changed as well. Credit can be expensive. We've got to be careful as borrowers, just as the banks have got to be careful as lenders.
Okay. Angela, thanks very much.
Thank you.
On BBC One, just after